Adelings, in this video we are going to discuss about the female reproductive organ of angiosperms, that is gynoecium. The female reproductive organ is the pistil, and each pistil has the three parts. The upper head-like or swollen-like part is known as the stigma, and this is the place where the male reproductive organ comes and falls. And below the stigma is a long, slender, stalk-like structure known as the style. And below the style is the swollen region known as the ovary. Inside this ovary, the ovule is present. And this ovary is attached to the thalamus or receptacle. In some flowers, only one pistil is found, and in some flowers, more than one pistil is found. And the flowers which contains only one pistil, such type of flowers are known as monocarpillary. And the flowers where more than one pistil are present, such type of flowers are known as multicarpillary. And in this multicarpillary, where all the pistils are free, they are not grouped, all pistils are free, such type of pistils are known as apocarpous. And in this multicarpillary, where all the pistils are grouped or fused together, such type of pistils are known as syncarpous. This style is of two types. One is allostyle and solid style. In this allostyle, this is the structure of only stigma and pistil. And the outer layer is surrounded by the epidermis cells, and in between this outer surface, the lumen or space is present. And in this space, the pollen tube grows and reaches to the ovary. But in solid style, in between these epidermis cells, other cells are present, and these cells are completely packed. Inside this ovary, the ovule is present. In this ovule, the embryo sac is present. In the embryo sac, the egg is present. Ovary. This is the ovary. Inside the ovary, the ovule is present. This ovule is attached to a tissue in the ovary known as the placenta, and the arrangement of this placenta is known as the placentation. This ovule has the two parts. One is stalk-like part, and there is the body part. This stalk-like part is known as the funicle, and body-like part. This body part has layer to protect it. And this protective layer is known as the integuments. And in case of angiosperms, two integuments are present. And presence of two integuments is known as the bitegments. But in angiosperms, only one integument is present. And such integument type is known as the unitegument. The place where this funicle is attached to the body part known as the ilium. And this funicle extends towards the body part. And that part which is extended towards the body part is known as the raphe. Inside this nucellus, inside this body part, many cells are present known as the nucellus. And if ovule has less nucellus, such type of ovule is known as tenui nucellate. And if this ovule have many nucellus, such type are known as the crossi nucellate. And the place where these integuments are open, such end is known as the micropyle end. And the place where this integument is closed, and that end is known as the chalaza end. Formation of female gametophyte, that is embryo sac. See, this is the ovary. Inside this ovary, the ovule is present. And this is the funicle. And the place where funicle is attached to the ovule is known as the ilium. In this ovule, many cells are present known as the nucellus. And one of the cell of this nucellus, which is present towards the micropyle end, will become bigger and known as the megaspore mother cell. This one of the cells of the nucleus which will become bigger, known as the megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell undergo meiotic division and forms four haploid cells known as megaspore tetraid. These are four haploid cells, and these are all combined together. That is why these are known as megaspore tetraid. And this megaspore tetraid is always linear. In this four megaspore tetraid, three will degenerate and only one megaspore will survive, and this surviving megaspore will develop into an egg. Now the surviving megaspore undergo mitotic division. In this mitotic division, first it undergo karyokinesis, means only nuclei divides, the cytoplasm distribution won't take place. And this nuclei divides three times. When this nuclei divides first time, it forms the two nuclei. And when nuclei divides second time, it forms the four nuclei. And when third time this nucleus divides, this all four nuclei divides into two and forms totally eight nuclei. And Now the cytokinesis takes place. Out of these 8 nuclei, only 6 nuclei will take cytoplasm and remaining 2 nuclei won't take cytoplasm. And out of these 8 nuclei, 3 nuclei and which is taken the cytoplasm, now they become cells. And these 3 cells move towards the chalazion end. And these 3 cells known as the antipodes. And remaining 3 cells came to the micropyle end. And these 3, out of these 3, the central present cell is long. And this is known as the egg. And remaining beside this egg is presented 2 cells known as the synergids. And this complete structure known, which is synergids and egg together known as the egg apparators. And the 2 nuclei which the cytoplasm won't take place remains at the middle and known as the polar nuclei. And this is the 8 nucleated and 7 celled stage. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 nuclei are present. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this complete 1 cell. Total 7 cells are present. And this is and presence of 8 nucleated and 7 celled stage are known as the polygonal type of the embryo sac. Types of ovules. And this type is based on the attachment of funicle to the body part of the ovule. First one, Arthrotropus. And this is the upright type. In this type, the micropyle end is towards the upper side and chalazion end towards the lower side, and all the micropyle chalaza are present in the same plane. This type of ovules are known as the Arthrotropus type, and this type is most common in gymnosperms. And second one type is Anatropus, and it is an inverted type. In this type, the micropyle end where the integuments are absent is known as the micropyle end, and this end is towards the lower side and chalaza end is towards the upper side. And next is the Emmetropus, and it is a transverse type. In this type, this micropyle chalaza end and the micropyle end is exactly right side to the funicle. That means it is exactly like a 90 degree. Another type is the Campylotropus. In this type, this same like Emmetropus, but this chalaza and micropyle end is bent more than 90 degree to the funicle. And fifth one, Amphitropus. This is same like Campylotropus, which is bent more than 90 degree to the funicle, but the ovule is horseshoe-shaped ovule is present. And presence of Anatotropus is a characteristic features of angiosperms. It is the most common in angiosperms.